The Delaware Department of Transportation, as we know it today, would have not existed if not for the Federal Highway Act of 1916, the Good Roads Movement, and T. Coleman DuPont. T. Coleman DuPont, great-grandson of the DuPont Company founder, observed bad roads and poor economic conditions in southern Delaware as he traveled from Wilmington to the lower eastern shore of Maryland. He understood that reliable transportation networks were essential for the economic development of the state. DuPont envisioned a 200-foot-wide right-of-way corridor with separate travel lanes dedicated for high-speed traffic, trolleys, trucks, horse-drawn wagons, and pedestrians, all of which would be equipped with landscaping. DuPont declared, "I'm going to build a monument 100 miles high and lay it on the ground." Starting in Sussex County in 1911, DuPont supervised design and construction of the first 30 miles of his two-lane concrete road himself, bypassing all towns with curves and grades adequate for high-speed traffic. It was the nation's first modern superhighway. He built and paid for a grand boulevard the length of Delaware himself at a cost of $2 million and then donated it to the citizens of Delaware. The straightest, widest, best road in the world, which stands today as the greatest personal gift in highway history. As we know it today, various bypasses have been installed and altered route names, but the original route can still be traveled. The DuPont Highway was completed by the State Highway Department in 1924 and was officially added to the United States Highway System in 1925. The Delaware Department of Transportation is grateful to T. Coleman DuPont for his vision for a grand transportation system and influencing the state to create the department as we know it today.